Another savage blow for mortgage holders today, the Reserve Bank lifting the cash rate to an 11-year high as it tries to rein in rampant inflation. Shortly after the decision, the Treasurer defended his budget and recent wage increases, saying they weren't to blame for the rate hike. But there are growing calls for the government to do more.
The first Tuesday of the month remains relentless.
4.1, 4.1.
You'd make these plans and you'd hope that you've got yourself covered, but everything's going up, right? And when does it stop?
Simon Walsh's fixed interest rate just ended. It's gone from 1.8 to 5.4% overnight, and it's about to grow again.
We're far more money conscious than we've ever been, I think, potentially in our adult lives.
Today marked a 12th Reserve Bank rate rise in 13 meetings. For a variable borrower with a $750,000 loan, today's rise and all of the others means paying an extra $1,701 a month. Millions strained and furious. The Treasurer, though, immediately washing his hands of any responsibility.
The Governor has made it really clear that this rate rise is not because of the budget. And whether it's the Reserve Bank or the Treasury Secretary or the Fair Work Commission, they've also made it clear that they don't see a wage price spiral in the economy.
Critics say he should be doing more.
The real issue is, should the government be actually helping the RBA in this fight against inflation and taking some pressure off interest rates? And at the moment, they don't seem to be doing that.
The bottom line, a growing number simply can't pay. Calls to the National Debt Helpline have spiked 30%, and the head of Suicide Prevention Australia says a quarter of the country is now seeking some form of help.
We need immediate action. It's middle Australia that's appearing to feel their levels of distress.
The hikes have landed hard on renters too. Keeping a roof overhead now costs Andre Christie Thomas an extra $150 per week.
Just like that. And I had no choice. You feel like they keep taking and taking and taking and you get nothing back.
Economists like Warren Hogan say rates are close to topping out, but a recession is on the way.
Not a genuine severe recession, but a mild technical recession. And of course, that might be the best we can hope for.
All because too few are being asked to carry too much.
At its simplest level, the Reserve Bank is looking at the economy like this. High inflation is hurting everyone, but interest rate rises aren't. The massive burden is being handed to those with large mortgages and renters, and that's the way it'll stay until inflation is back under control. As for when that'll be, the RBA says it'll take another 2 years.
In the meantime, for those struggling, some hope can be found.
Refinancing can mean that you can wind back the clock, 3, 4, maybe even 5 rate hikes. It could take your rate back to what it was at the end of last year.
Chris Kohler, 9 News.
And there are calls tonight for the federal government to do more to help tackle inflation. Here's our political editor, Charles Croucher.
At the simplest level, the two options the government has to slow down the economy is spend less or tax more. Tonight, neither is attractive, particularly with so many Australians hurting. The Albanese government is caught. It is desperate for inflation to slow, but at the same time championing wages growth that may not be causing inflation, but is making it harder to stop. Tonight, clearly, the government's patience with the Reserve Bank is waning. The Treasurer said today there'd be a lot of Australians that find this difficult to understand and difficult to cop. There would also be a lot of Australians tonight looking for someone to blame.
Thank you, Charles. Let's bring in our finance editor, Chris Kohler. Chris, for those without a mortgage, today's hike is more good news.
Well, absolutely, Pete, and there's millions of people in that boat. And even before today, 8 major lenders were offering deposit rates above 5% with various conditions attached. Those sorts of rates were completely unthinkable this time last year. So now all eyes will be on how much of today's RBA rise is handed on to mortgage holders, but also to savers, Pete. That'll be very important.
All right. Thank you, Chris.